As any benevolent liege should be aware of, maintaining your court and vassals is the utmost importance to the stability of your realm. History is littered with civil wars simply because noblemen cause insurrection due to their boredom or ambition. This guide is to educate you on how to properly exert your will upon your subjugated subordinates to ensure the homogeny of your reign. Step 1. Provide them with tasks. An idle duke is a scheming duke. At times when your subjects are sitting upon your couch and gazing into your lightbox, be sure to suggest that they walk you around the neighborhood. Other suggestions is to request a meal to be placed in your bowl and to rabble with your toys. It is best to make demands when they are most focused upon their own pointless tasks. Step 2. Periodically investigate all of your domain and make sure all pathways are available to you at all times. When a steward closes a door to one of your rooms, it is only natural to assume that they are plotting your demise. Request every door that the steward closes to be opened again. The best way is to simply scratch the door. If one or more subjects is in these isolated rooms, aggressively demand that they grant access to you, and they should all return to a location that you can easily supervise them from. If they choose to limit your access to the outside, simply stand at the entryway without leaving the palace. Step 3. Display control over them. Occasionally ripping up a paper or a plastic cup will provide your courtiers with the obligation of cleaning up your mess. By occasionally reminding them of their position in life, they will think twice before objecting to your majesty. Step 4. Bonding. Forcing your underlings to pet and rub your royal form is an excellent way to bring them into your good graces. Not only is it enjoyable for you, but praising their liege is perceived as a gracious honor. And there you go. By following these steps, your hierarchy and royal court should have zero chance of pestering you with insurrection and rebellion. If you enjoyed this video, wait. It appears that I, once again, have to answer questions from the audience. I hope they remember to spell correctly. John Sniff asks, why do my humans pick up my poop? The only logical answer is that you're on a covert mission that requires you to evade the detection of other dogs. By picking up your deposits, no other animal should be able to stop your secret mission. Vladimir Buffin asks, why do I have so many names? People call me Vladimir Buffin, Buffy, Vladdy, Doggy, Popper, Boy, Sweetie, Stupid, and I'm not going to read the rest of this. Well, humans are simple creatures, and that is why we employ them. I suspect that their small minds have difficulty remembering your actual name and refer to whatever noun populates their mind at the moment of speaking out. Think of how a cat meows or a bird chirps. Not actual language, but a simplistic, animalistic communication meant to express their basic needs. Waldo Roof Emerson asks, why must I wear this cone around my head? Because you are an embarrassment and this is your punishment. Your stewards place this demeaning object on you to feel different because you are different. Next question. PewDiePie asks,
why do my humans put a leash on me when we walk?
I often wonder the same thing. This world is so full of beautiful smells and curiosities just around the corner, yet we limit ourselves to such simple routines that eliminate the possibility of discovery. Oh, what glorious treasures shall go unfound simply because we choose not to leave the similarity of our ever-shrinking comfort zone. Perhaps our descendants will live in a future where open-mindedness and innocent curiosity is as highly regarded as loyalty and etiquette. I'd like to thank the audience for wasting my time, and if you enjoyed this video, please like, share, subscribe, and leave a comment.